Debra, thanks for coming. It's nice to see you again.
Thanks. Well, you wanted to see me, right?
Yeah, first, how was the flight?
Oh, it was good, and can you believe they lost my luggage?
Oh, I hate the airline people. They'll do it to you all the time.
I know, but well, it was sweet for you to ask me.
Yeah, well, thank you. Listen, before I start talking, first let me ask, how is Steve?
Well, he's a little ticked off, but...
ticked off at me?
Yeah, I think you know why.
I do know why, but I'll tell you what, I have some news that I think might make him feel a little better. You see, because I was doing some thinking, and I realized that even though Steve being run over by a car was unquestionably a horrible tragedy, not everything that happened as a result of that was all that horrible, was it?
What's he mean?
I don't know.
Let me make myself a little clearer. When Steve was hurt, he needed somebody to be there for him, to take care of him and nurture him, bring him back to health, right?
Mick, what are you getting at here?
I never really had the chance to ask you, you know, how was the wedding? Honeymoon? Oh. Went all right?
Oh, yeah.
What I'm saying is, look, it's no secret. Wives hate the life of a professional wrestler. Steve was on the road more than 250 days in a year, being beaten up, worn down, long, lonely nights on the road. And what I'm wondering, Debra, is, did you hate that life enough to possibly do something about it?
No, I'll tell you one thing, Mick, and that Steve Austin is my husband, and I love him very, very much. And I had to sit there every day and watch him hurt. And that is the hardest thing that I've ever had to do in my life. And I'll tell you one thing, Mick Foley, I am just so thankful that Steve stunned you out there. I just regret that I wasn't out there with him. Thank you.
Debra, don't leave the arena just yet, okay?
Yeah, right.
Have a nice day.